Hi there. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at this four troller set from Wings. Model is Goose and the color is coffee. And they should be ultra light. We'll be the judge of that. So let's start unboxing them, unwrapping them actually. That's kind of anticlimactic. The color, I honestly from the picture wasn't sure about it. We have natural light here, so this is the real color that you see during daylight. Let me try maybe get a bit more light onto them. Honestly, I like it. I like it a lot. It's not black. It's brown, subtle brown. Yeah, good. So, this set, let me check exactly how expensive it was. Okay, so this was again four troller set from their Polish website, and it costed about $93 shipping included, in my case to Romania. So that's actually pretty cool. Let's start getting these things out. As you can see, there are a lot of them because each one of them has this thing. So they are one into the other in here. It's going to be a bit tricky to film. Not using a tripod or so. Oh, I thought this was bent, but no, this is its design, which I quite like. Interesting. And yeah, it's actually at the end of it. So it seems the front of the first one opens something like this. Not like I initially thought. This is a bit interesting, so let me try and put it on a side and be back in a second. Okay, I've opened it up also here, and yes, these are 360 degrees rotating, and for me it was really important to have the wheels as much tucked in as possible, because if you have big wheels like that in an airplane, depending if it's carry-on luggage and depending on the airline, this might be a limiting factor, so you cannot take your luggage with you. With these smaller wheels, which are actually rubber, you can see it clearly here, camera, please focus, my fingernail is going a bit into them, this will not make too much noise, and they are small. So they are ticking all the boxes. Camera, focus. And yes, my lovely assistant wife is helping me, and all the little trollers are actually in here. So let's start to somehow get them out of here. And they have a weird way of actually packaging them, because this one would not actually fit inside of this one if it had the wheels on. So its wheels are somewhere, probably inside of it, that would make sense. So let's get them. Okay, we took the smaller ones out and we are looking at the biggest one to get it out of the way when we finish. And yes, it has a second zipper which allows it to become a bit bigger. So about 5 centimeters bigger, which in some cases would help a lot. We've all been at the moment when our troller was just a smidge too full, but enough so you cannot close it. Well, this helps you in exactly that situation, and you obviously can simply ignore that and close it all around and only use the zipper that actually opens this thing in two. You have a flap right here in the middle that also has a zipper all around, something like this. So if you want to separate the things, sorry, it's a bit hard to film honestly. The zippers, for me, they seem really good quality. I don't know if they are a known brand like YKK or something. I don't see any text on them anywhere. Maybe on the external ones. No, I don't see anything anywhere. But they could still be a known brand, but I don't see any text. If you want to separate stuff, yes, you have this possibility to put unmentionables here. And for general use, the rest of it, which is huge in this particular troller, I'm not sure. I think they were saying on the website something like 94 liters or something like that. I'm going to put the sizes as a text next for all of them. Okay, that's out of the way. And now you can also open this thing up as usual and put a lot of stuff in here. Polish, Russian, I don't know any of those. French, English, okay, we know a bit of English. Yes, so for the lock, how to change its code. And we have the lock right somewhere. Lock, where are you? If we could actually find the lock. Yeah, here it was. Okay, so this is the lock. It should be open in theory. Or actually, no, I think this rotated and that is why it's not opening. It should be a zero. Come on, zero. Yep, and now it's opening. So that's that, and if you rotate it, not opening anymore. Quite simple. Yeah, this is not for security. This is just for a bit of safety, but yeah, if somebody wants, it can rip this apart and open it. These things, quite interesting design. And they are decently flat. I've seen some with huge handles. I hate those. So this seems good. Let me rip off these protections. Yeah, just wanted to add, obviously, yeah, I think I got something on it. You actually also have this to keep stuff from flying around if this thing is not full, or to organize a bit better. And yes, the wheels, even if they are a bit tucked in, they don't intrude too much in here. And also, the part of the mechanism from the handle is in here, but it's much thinner than in many that I've seen, which were about this thick. So again, you have decent space in here, doesn't occupy too much. And I think, yeah, it has here an anchoring point, so, and one here, obviously. Let's see if there is anything interesting in here. This is their website. Again, Wings Goose. 2 years warranty. Yep. I kind of like these leaflets, or how you want to call them. Let's see. Do we have some English somewhere? Yes, we have some English somewhere. So if you want to read this thing, could be a bit difficult because of the way they used something similar to gold leaf, I think it's called. Anyway, there's that, never mind. Ooh, and now that I've taken out that protection, this thing has something that looks like soft rubber, or actually silicone maybe. Not sure what it is, but it's really extremely nice on the hand, honestly. Does the other one also have it and I haven't noticed? Where are you? Yep, it has it. That's cool. That's honestly really cool. Yes, and let's peel this off. Oh, that's again anticlimactic because it was in there. Express. I have no idea what they mean with that. But as far as stickers go, always peel them as soon as you get the product. because most of them handle sun, for example, ultraviolet, sorry about the noise, ultraviolet light really badly, and if you leave them on even for a short while, maybe one or two travels, you might have a problem that they will leave residue or barely come out. So get rid of them. And yes, it seems this does attract, or is this from the factory? Maybe it's a bit of dust from the factory, or could be a bit of electrostatic buildup on this, because it's a plastic. So I think it's ABS or something like that. Anyway, pretty good. This seems like a decent plastic, but from the feel of it, it might actually crack in case you hit it really hard with something. It doesn't give me the feel of a deformable plastic. So it's quite strong, but could be a bit brittle in case you really, really impact it. But yeah, it needs to be a stiff plastic to hold these things in place. So yeah, don't smash this really hard onto something, I guess. Okay, and we are almost done with this one. Let's see how nicely this thing opens up. Okay, satisfying click. No rubber anywhere on this thing. But yeah, you are not pulling the whole weight, you are only rolling it around. So there is not such a big need for rubber like on this one. Do not hurt your hand. Let's see, are we at the max? Yes, we are at the max, but hey, this is really tall. I'm 1.83 centimeters, and this is, you can see how I'm holding it, so this is tall. And this is the middle position. Oh, this one actually has, so 1, 2, 3. Okay, and let's see how light it is. Okay, so this is light. This is quite light. We have an X Club, I think is the brand, a similar ABS, if I remember correctly. It's a similar plastic, but another color, never mind. And that one is about the same weight, but it's even smaller than the second size from this set. So yeah, this in my opinion is quite light. Good. Let's get to the others. The second size, a bit smaller one, has exactly the same features all over. It's an identical copy of the big one, just scaled a little bit. So yeah, not much to say. It also has this feature that it can extend if you need to, with this right here. Let's see if I can do it with one hand. And I cannot do it, so be back in a second. And the extension has about the same size, again about 5 centimeters. This fit, the big one also has them. So on one side you have the handle and the lock, and on the other you have 4 feet. And yes, seems this is a bit of a fluff magnet. If you put it onto some carpet or something like that, it will attract all the fluff from it. But hey, that's plastic for you. But I think also a material one, cloth one, would gather in it and would be even worse to clean. So yeah, that's about it. That's, again, this is a carbon copy of the big one. Let me see how many levels we have for this thing. It will actually stay, let me close it. Some other thing. So you can use the lock. They are designed to use the lock, obviously. You can see this in here, which enters perfectly in the lock right there. Let me actually lock them. But you can also use your own little lock. Something like this, if you want to put in there, you can do it. And this lock isn't made for idiots like me, so maybe you have more experience with this and you know how to use it. Like an idiot, I was trying to get it open, and now in this open position trying to put these things in, and they obviously don't go in. But a sane person that actually has traveled a bit and has used more of these things with locks, mine actually have really weird locks that I never used, know that you only push this and it's locked. Push this and it's locked, and to unlock them you only pull on this and it throws them out. So this lock is a bit smarter than I am, and much smarter than the ones that I had on previous bags. Now let's see. Yep, obviously lighter than the other one. The specs are on the website, I will put a link, and let's see how many steps this one has. So it's 1, 2, 3 and 4. So again, I'm at about the same level as with the big one. So this has more travel to reach in the end the same level, which is high, much higher than you would actually need in my opinion, but maybe you are really tall. So yeah, that's that. Let's get to the next ones. Okay, on to the almost smallest one, because we have one even smaller. Inside, same compartments, everything is the same, but we don't have that extra extension. We have this thing, and yeah, and I really like that all of them open like this. The old ones that we have, not sure if both of them, but at least no one of them opens like this on the length, so it's huge when it's open like this. On the half, for me, it's much better. I think our smaller La Monza, if, and that one is about the size of this one, opens like this and it's much better. So yeah, not really anything else to tell you about this thing, because it's a carbon copy of the other two without that 5 centimeter extension. They don't, you don't lose any other features by going smaller with these things, which is quite okay. So let's see how many levels this thing has. So it's okay. I think this one actually goes a bit different than the others, because it has a telescopic extension, so it can reach even higher. So no level up until now, nothing yet. Okay, we have a level right here, and this is the final, which again, look at my hand, I'm almost at 90 degrees. So this is as high as you would ever want it. It's huge, it's almost longer than it is. And the metal, most likely 99.99% is aluminium. Yes, you have the Wings logo, quite nice. So this thing has basically, as you can see from the holes, 2 levels. Yeah, you could in theory use it even if at this one, because you can push it around as you want, but it's not locked. So go down and it's closed. Let's go to the smallest. Okay, we are looking at the smallest one, and this comes with a bit of dust. I think it's dust, probably from the factory, but yeah, obviously you need to, yeah, it's dust. You need to clean these things up yourself. From storage, I expect this to be. The lock is still there. We don't have the side handle, but for this particular size, which is, I don't know, about 45 centimeters tall, you don't need the side handle, honestly. No matter who you are, you should be able to use this handle. Still opening up in half, which is perfect. Let's hope we get the wheels, and this thing actually has the possibility to remove the wheels. So we are losing the handle, but we are gaining this thing, which is awesome and could be really handy on airports and inside the plane. So the others don't have this feature. Let's see inside, and we should find the wheels. My wife is saying that maybe with the wheels it's just above what some airlines allow. So they were really sneaky and made the wheels removable, so you have the absolute maximum volume possible with the wheels in your pocket or even inside of it, but they are not giving you extra length. Good on them. And yes, we do have the wheels. So let's install them, and they are quite heavy. So the wheels themselves, I had no idea they are this heavy. Should be quite good quality. Let me see if I can actually see a bearing in there. The internal construction, identical like for the others, which in my opinion is really good. So yeah, let's put on the little wheels. I cannot see any bearings in there, and it seems to be moving from one side to the other on the metal shaft itself. So that could mean that we don't actually get bearings, it's plastic on metal. Although, from the sound of it, we do have bearings. Come on, camera, focus. So not really sure, maybe the bearings are not fully locked onto the shaft, or I'm not sure. So then don't take this from me. I'm not sure what I'm looking at here. Thick rubber, that I can tell you for a fact. So it shouldn't make noise and should be nice to carry, because whatever we have here is quite smooth. So let's see how we put these things on. Push them in there and probably hold this thing. And yep, it's locked in place. 360 moving, that's awesome. To get it out, push and unlock it. To get it in again, push and push it in, locked in place. So let's put all of them in. Wheels are on, and it's actually really smart of them. They might be sticking out a bit more than in the other sizes. So they are trying to give you as much of internal room as possible in this one, because you can do this thing. I really like to take them off, I don't know why. And again, a really smart thing that they took them out when they shipped them to actually somehow showcase this possibility and to force you to understand that they are removable. Because many people, if they get them like this, they will not read a manual or anything like that, so they might never know that you can remove them. But like this, from the start, you know it's a possibility if you ever need it. We still have the lock on this thing. Yes, some tiny scratches. Or actually, no, my bad, they are not scratches. You know what they are? They are from the tool. So this is a bit of a burr from the tool. And it's really, really fine. And the second you will start using this thing, it will break away. Think of it as the little burrs that you see on new car tires. It's just from the way these molds close, and they don't affect anything and don't tell us anything about the quality. If you would have some burrs that you cannot actually take off like this easily with your finger, that tells you about the quality of the mold. It's not quite closing perfectly, but this one's non-issue. Now let me close this thing up again. No possibility to open it up more, it's tiny, so yeah. And let's see how long this thing extends and how light it is. I wasn't sure, honestly, about the color. Initially wanted to get them on a blue, but the dark blue wasn't available anymore, and the light blue was a bit too light and too in your face for us. So again, we went this, and silicone is present in all four sizes. We went with this coffee color, and honestly, we kind of like it. So it's good. Let's open this thing up. Again, up until here, no locking position. Still coming out. Still coming out. Or, I think I need to press it once again. Or might need the second hand to hold on to it. It could be a bit stuck, as you can see, one of them came out and that there is a big stuck in there. A bit, sorry, stuck. Correction, it's stuck in here actually, not in there. So this could be causing a bit of an issue. Let me see how to get it unstuck. Yeah, I simply pushed it all the way down and it became unstuck by itself. So that's that. And it's coming up again now. Is it? Yeah, it seems to be coming up again now. But I don't think it matters. At this point, no, it doesn't really matter. Is this the max? Yep, and my hand is basically in almost the same position. So this is a tiny bit lower than the others, but maybe about this much. Or could be exactly the same and I just have the feeling. But again, it's extremely long and you can carry this all any way you want around the airport. And I do much prefer these things compared to the ones that you need to take with you like this. This is on your side and you can go like this if you want. And my camera will not focus on anything today, so I'm really, really sorry about that. Okay, let's see how many positions. So there's one, there's two. This is not a position, this is one. Again, this is one, final one. And from here on, I think we have none. Yes, we have no position until closing. And yes, it's locked in place. So that's about that. I honestly really like them, and let me see if I can put them all one next to the other. Okay, so we have here all four trawlers, and honestly, I really like them. My wife really likes them, and as soon as the restrictions allow us, we will start putting them to the test. But for the moment, we are probably be going inside the house from one room to the other with them, just to practice carrying a trawler. So that's about it. Hope this video helps somebody out there to make a decision about them. They seem really good quality, decent amount of features in my opinion, for me at least, for our family. There is no feature that's missing. And yeah, again, hope this video helps you, in which case please give it a like, check out my other videos, and as always, see you in the next one, and bye.